I believe that almost everybody knows me, but maybe it would be not a bad idea to introduce myself. I'm ambassador of Republic of Poland to the Kingdom of Norway. My name is Stefan Czmur. I will be the first speaker, and I believe that also the last one during summary session, let's say. Distinguished members of the Polish Parliament, Director Anders Erdal, Director Artur Orzechowski, distinguished guests, dear panelists, ladies and gentlemen. I am very pleased to welcome you to this conference about the Polish community in Norway. The fact that Poles have become the largest foreign national group in Norway has its implications in various areas. The present conference shall focus on the social, economic and legal aspects of Polish immigration to Norway and explore the opportunities and challenges arising within these areas from the presence of Poles in Norway. As Prime Minister Erna Solberg stressed during her visit to Poland last week, Poles are a good example of integration and, I quote, their work constitutes an important contribution to maintain the Norwegian welfare, end of quotation. In this context, we should bear in mind that Poles have become a part of Norway in many fields. Some of them have made outstanding careers, and it is important, the common perception of the Polish community in Norway includes these people alongside craftsmen and workers. Embassy of the Republic of Poland tries to promote achievements of eminent representatives of the Polish community by supporting the Outstanding Pole in Norway contest, which is organized each year in Oslo. The Outstanding Pole in Norway title can be awarded in 5 categories: business, personality, science, culture, and the young Pole. Prize winners to date include writers, university professors, and even the first Norwegian Olympic medalist in fencing, Bartosz Piasecki. I am grateful to Norwegian authorities for according their attention to the contest and their presence during the prize award ceremonies. We should make the contest even more visible so that the contribution these eminent personalities make the Norwegian society becomes a new characteristic of the Polish community in Norway. Presence of Poles in Norway is an important element of political relation between our states. Foundation for that is Poland's membership in the European Union and, by extension, in the European economic area. This year we celebrate 10 years of our EU membership, and we need to remember that Poland's membership in the EU also entails the Polish-Norwegian cooperation within the EEA. On 10 of October, we celebrate 10 years of Polish-Norwegian cooperation through EEA and Norwegian grants. Also, the present conference is supported by the EEA and Norway grants, and I find it fitting to extend most heartfelt thanks to our Norwegian partners for this 10 years of fantastic cooperation. The conference, the Polish community in Norway, opportunities and challenges, gathers eminent expert and representative of Polish and Norwegian institutions participating in EEA cooperation. I extend a special welcome to members of Polish Parliament, Mr. Maciej Wydrzyński, Mr. Piotr Chmielowski, Mr. Piotr Pyzik, and Mr. Damian Raczkowski. And I thank them that they have found time to participate in the conference, and especially in the really busy time for Polish politicians. I greatly value the presence of representative of Polish and Norwegian foreign minister, Mr. Artur Orzechowski, and Mr. Anders Erdal. And I'm very glad that representative of Norwegian and Polish Institute of International Affairs, Peace Research Institute, Oslo, FAFO, Institute for Labor and Social Research, Norwegian Center for Minority Health Research, and last but by far not least, Arts Council Norway, have joined us today. Cultural cooperation through the EA and Norwegian Grants, managed by the Polish Minister of Culture and National Heritage and Arts Council Norway, is, in fact, one of the most prominent and noticeable forms of our EA cooperation. It truly brings our countries and people closer to each other. The conference consists of three panels focusing respectively on social, economic, and cultural aspects of Polish immigration to Norway. The first panel should be moderated by Dr. Jakub Gojimirski, who is the senior researcher in the Norwegian Institute of International Affairs, a recognized expert on Russia and energy, and, not least, one of our prize winners of the Outstanding Poll in Norway contest in 2012. The second panel shall be moderated by Mr. Lars Kåre Lægernes. Where he is? Mr. Lægernes is the managing director of the Oslo Chamber of Commerce. The panel of cultural aspects of Polish immigration to Norway shall be moderated by Dr. Marcin Fronia, who is the executive director of the Northern Centrum Foundation and the former visiting scholar to the University in Oslo in the Norwegian Institute of International Affairs. Mr. Fronia is the author of the publication on sociology of development, modernization of Poland, conflict prevention, energy security, and climate change. I welcome the distinguished moderators of all panels. Before I give the floor to the representative of the Polish and Norwegian Minister of Foreign Affairs, I want to mention that conference materials on today's discussion should be published shortly. I would also like to introduce my deputy, Mr. Marian Siemakowicz. This is the man. Who will be, let's say, playmakers for the conference. He will announce any important information regarding the organization of our conference. Now be careful of this guy. Distinguished guests, dear panelists, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for your attention. Now I have the pleasure to give the floor to Mr. Anders Erdal, Director of the Europe and Trade Department of the Royal Norwegian Minister of Foreign Affairs. Mr. Erdal, the floor is yours.